in the end of Sefer Bereishis. So the pasuk says that Yaakov dies, and Yosef's brothers are very scared, they're very worried. The pasuk says, Perek Nun Pasuk Tezvah, Vayu Ache Yosef Kimeis Aviyahem. The brothers of Yosef saw that his father died. Their father died. Vayomru Luis Tamenu Yosef. They're scared that now Yosef is going to get all upset at them for everything that he did to them. Vahashev Yashiv Lanu is Kol Arash or Gamal Lanu also. And he's going to pay us back with bad on the evil Asher Gamal Lanu also that we did for him. Focus on the word Gamal, okay? They performed evil to him, so he's gonna now pay us back. They don't have their father anymore to protect them. They're in trouble. Okay, so Vayitzavu Yosef Leimor, the pasuk continues and says that they commanded Yosef, saying that before Yaakov died, he told us to give you the following message. Kosav okay. Yosef, tell Yosef that we should forgive the sins. Kira'a gemalucha. Again, for the evil that was done to you. Okay. So now the Rishonim asked the following question. What is this word gamal? Gimul. When you want to say someone did something to someone else, you say asa, asu. So here, why all of a sudden the lashon, the usage of the word gamalanu, gamalnu, that he was gomel to them? Should have just said that the evil that they did, Shehim Asu, to Yosef. So what does it mean? So the Rabbeinu Ephraim, one of the Balei Tosos, he has two different explanations in his commentary on the Chumash. He has two different explanations for this word. Explanation number one is that the word Gemalucha means to pay back, a payment. The evil reports that Yosef brought to their father, right? So it was a payment, that which they did, the ra, the bad that they did to him, was a payment back to him. So the payment to him was for, what did he do? He did something wrong to them. He gave an evil report to his father, and they were gomel to him. They paid him back with selling him down to Mitzrayim. The word gemalucha means to pay back. Okay, that's explanation number one. Explanation number two, he says, is that what is it that the brothers were gmalucha? What was the ra that they did, gmalu, to him? He says the word gamal here refers to another word of the another usage of the word gamal, and that is earlier in Parshas Vayera, where the pasuk says in Perek Chaf Aleph, Pasuk Ches 21:8, Vayigdal Ayelet Vayigamel, that the child grew up, and Vayigamel was weaned off of nursing. The word gamal also means when someone stops nursing, they're gimul. They wean them off. We wean the baby off. What in the world does this have to do with this week's parsha? This pasuk in this week's parsha. What did the brothers wean Yosef? What does that mean? So he explains. He says that the word is related to weaning a baby off nursing, making him separate and independent from his parent. So too, even though Yosef, he was 17, but 17 years old, he's a young kid, when he was taken away from his father, he still needed that connection that with his father. And it's considered a tragedy that he was disconnected, it was severed, that relationship between Yaakov and Yosef. It was like weaning a child off of his mother, excuse me, separated him. And that was the gamal that the brothers did to Yosef. They made him independent. They weaned him off from his father, took him away from his father during his years, his formative years at the age of 17. It was so important. So you have two explanations. What does it mean that the brothers were gomel ra'ah? They did bad to Yosef. One, it means to pay back. Yosef brought the dreams, the evil report to his father. They paid him back. That was number one. Number two is that they severed the relationship between him, Yosef, and his father. And like weaning off a baby, gimul, that's what they did to him, and that was the evil that they did, and that's why I use this lashon of gamal. Okay. Two explanations for the same word. So we know, in the Hebrew language, you can't have two different explanations for the same word. You can't have one explanation that means to pay back, and one explanation to mean to wean off. There has to be some common theme and meaning behind these two different words. Okay. So the idea is as follows, and we're going to see how it's related to our everyday life. The word gamal in Hebrew is a camel. Because now we have three words. Gamal means to pay back. Gamal means to wean a baby off of nursing. And it also means a camel. What is the connection between the three? A camel is the only animal that could be independent for such a long period of time. It could carry water in its back for such a long period of time that, as opposed to other animals, have to run to get some water, have to run in order to survive, they can hold their own for a long time. That's why you have the camels in the desert, because they're okay. The word gamal means to be independent. When you go ahead and you wean a baby off of its mother, it stops nursing. The reason the word gimul is used is because the baby is now independent. I think in modern Hebrew now they also use it for toilet training, for when a child stops using diapers. It's also you do gimul. You make them independent. They can function on their own. The word means independent. What does that have to do with paying back? So when I do something for someone, okay, and let's say a favor. So I do someone a favor. So now he feels indebted to me. He feels latched on to me. He feels he owes me. He feels like, you know, anything I'm going to ask him, I can't manipulate him. He owes me one. He owes me one, right? He's not independent. When you receive something from someone else, automatically there's a connection between you and that person. But if you pay the person back, so then you feel independent. No one ever thought, if you went to a store and bought a bag of potato chips, right, and the guy gave you the chips, you know, say, ooh, I owe this guy. He owes you nothing. He ripped you off. You paid him for the money. You paid him for the potato chips. And you don't feel any connection to the guy. But if he gave it to you as a present, then you do feel something. Paying back is a form of feeling independence. And that's why this word is used throughout all of those different expressions. We say in Shmona Esrei, Gomel Chasadim Tovim, a praise of Hashem, that Hashem is Gomel Chesed. What does it mean, Gomel Chesed? So we all probably translate it as He does Chesed. He does Chesed for us. But now we know that that's not the proper word. We should have said Osa Chesed. He does Chesed. What's Gomel Chesed? Gomel means to pay back. So what does it mean? So the Sefer Aksav HaKabbalah, we've quoted him before, in his Perish on Chumash, on the Siddur, sorry, the Iyun Tefillah, he asks the following question. He says, actually, Gomel Chasadim is a contradiction. Because the Gra writes in Mishle, in Perek Yedal Pasuk Chav Beis, 1422, he says that Gomel means to pay back, and Chesed means to initiate, not as a payment. When you give someone a freebie, that's a chesed. When you give someone because they did something to you, that's gomel. So gomel chesed is a contradiction. You don't gomel chesed. Chesed is if you're not giving them anything back at all. You're just initiating the whole thing. It's from scratch. Gomel is he did something to you and you're giving it back. You can't be gomel chesed. It's impossible. That's his question. So he says the following idea. He says that he doesn't quote this, but the Ramchal writes in Das Tfunos, the why is it, if Hashem, the whole purpose of creation, creating the world, is to give us good, right? Hashem's the ultimate good, and Hashem just wants to give us the good. So the obvious question is, great, so just like give it to us. Like, why do I have to come down to this world, and why do I have to, you know, have difficulties, and why do I have to work hard? Just give it to me. Give me the good. No, work hard so that I can ultimately get the good when I go to Olam Haba. Just give it to me. You're so good, just give it to me. So why does Hashem come along and force us to work and make us do mitzvos and make us earn the good? So the Das Tfunos Ramchal explains, because the natural way of a human being is that if I go ahead and I get a freebie, I feel ashamed. And it doesn't feel so good. Right? No one likes taking handouts. No one likes getting stuck. No one likes always having to be dependent on other people. It's very, very uncomfortable, right? So in order for us to feel like we earned the good, which is the ultimate good. The ultimate good is when you're the bialim, you're the owners of the good. It's yours, you earned it, you got it. That's the ultimate good. So in order to give us that feeling, Hashem put us in this world and said, now work for it. So when you go ahead and we do a mitzvah, we put on our tefillin, when we speak nicely, we do achnasas orchim, whatever good that we do, we then get good and we feel we earned it. So we have the ultimate good. So Hashem is gomel. He's gomel, meaning he gives us as a payback to that which we've done on our own. Why does he do it? In order so that we could feel no shame. We don't feel connected. We feel like we earned it and we get it. However, we all know that it's really not true. Because every single second that I breathe, every single second that I do anything, I'm more in debt to Hashem. So we would start like, you know, raking up all the good that Hashem does for us, all the chesed that Hashem does. It doesn't hold a candle to the fact that we put on film today, Hashem. Let's go. You know, come on, it's a joke. Literally a joke, right? So really the whole thing's a chesed. Hashem is initiating. Hashem is going way beyond anything that we deserve. Hopefully we'll act that same way with our friends and our family and other people. Not just because, even if they don't deserve it, even if they did something wrong to us, we're still going to give to them. That's what Hashem does. Hashem is, the Baal Chesed means he does it even when we don't deserve anything. But Hashem does it in a way that it's gomel. Hashem does it in a way that we feel like it's a payback for everything that we have done, which is the ultimate chesed, and that's why it's chesedim tovim. Why do we say chesedim tovim? Isn't every chesed good? So it's gomel chesedim tovim because this is a special type of chesed because it's done in a way that we don't feel obligated. We don't feel necessarily that we need Hashem. We feel like we earned it. We feel like we've gotten it. We feel independent. We feel severed from the one that's giving to us. This is a very important lesson in how we try to give to other people. Everyone's involved in chesed. Everyone wants to try to help people. Everyone's trying to be makari people. Everyone's trying to teach people. We're all involved in chesed all day and all night. We're thinking about other people. But we have to become sophisticated chesed people. Right? We can't get stuck in the box of what people call chesed. Say, oh yeah, you can go there and you do a chesed activity. Like, chesed is our whole life. We're always involved in chesed. Even when we're learning Torah. Learning Torah is chesed. We're giving much good to the entire world. We're always involved in chesed. But we have to become sophisticated, professional chesed people. So how do we do that? Our ultimate goal is that we should be gomel chesed. We should do it in a way that we wean people off, that they're not dependent on us, that they don't just care about that we did something good and check. It should be in a way that the person feels independent. That's why the Rambam's highest level of giving tzedakah is that you give someone a job, right? Because what happened? You found the guy a job. He doesn't even know you found him the job. Right? You keep him behind the scenes. He doesn't feel he got anything from anyone. He thinks he just got the job. So now he has a job. He's making money, supporting his family, right? All because of you. That's the greatest chesed. Because it was without the shame of that I got it from someone else. No favor, you don't have to pay back to anyone. It's all you. That's the greatest level of chesed. And we have to try to do that. We have to try to think always when we're helping other people, are we allowing them to become independent? Or by us helping them, are they going to require my help forever? You know, some people are in situations that's the case. Okay, so you got to do it. But the ultimate way is to try to build people that they can stand on their own two feet, that they're not going to need you. And maybe that will require a little more investment in the beginning. Maybe it'll require a little more money in the beginning. Maybe it'll require more attention in the beginning. But ultimately, the person could do it on their own. They could stand on their own two feet. That's gimul. That's the way HaKadosh Baruch Hu does it. And we have to try to make sure that as long as we're doing chesed, sometimes a lot of fanfare with the chesed. It's exciting. It looks cool. It's, you know, people look up to you now because you do a lot of chesed. It's a very dangerous thing. Very dangerous thing because then people feel indebted to you. That's not the ultimate chesed. We want that the chesed should be like almost as if you don't even know it had anything to do with you. You don't care about it. So, you know, it's all for that other person. You want to try to give them that independence. So we have to try to think about this. This is very, very important in our lives. In yeshiva, we also have opportunities to do chesed. Now, a bunch of people that are sick in yeshiva, we can help them. We try to figure out what's the greatest way that we can help. We don't have to run far and wide necessarily to do chesed. A lot of people that need our help. Unfortunately, as we all know, when it's your roommate and it's your friend and it's a guy in yeshiva and it's not so exciting, so it's, come on, I'm not going to do it. He'll be fine. He'll get better by tomorrow. No, that's where it starts. That's where it starts, at home. And if a people can't do it in the yeshiva, you can't do it with your friends, then you're never going to be able to do it with your wife. You're never going to be able to do it with your kids because there, for sure, there's no fanfare, and there it's all the time, so it's not going to happen. So we have to try to look out. We should be looking out all the time for our friends, making sure that we're taking care of them. Everyone has to take care of each other, but you should take care of them in a way that they're not latched onto you and you're always needy, always needing you. Because at the end of the day, it's not really going to help them. We want to try to allow people to get into their own two feet, that they can make decisions, that they can be able to be successful on their own. And Be'ezus Hashem, if everyone does this, so we'll see that the greater success of all of us, of all of Klal Yisrael, will be on a much higher level. Shavua Tov.